We're here today at Murphy Seafood in Hammond with two of the four generations of the owners.
I'm Phillip Graziano and my father, Phil Graziano.
Well, we're really excited to be able to do this interview today. I know you guys have a lot going on, from your 60th anniversary to the Legacy Award you recently won. But before we get into that, I'd like to know a little bit about your history of the restaurant, because you guys have been a Hammond staple for many years.
We started Murphy's, my mother, my dad, and myself, 1963, March 13th, 1963, in our original place, which was on a corner of Highway 51 and Blackburn Road, with the little white house with the Coca-Cola signs in the front. We had a real large place there. We had a whole five tables, and of course the little oyster bar, and we were there until July the 8th, 1968, when we built the original building down here. And in 1985, we did our first addition. And of course, we've remodeled and fixed it many, many times, different things. And pretty much everything has stayed the same. All the values of when we first started, you know, everything homemade, all the family working. And I always say, in the older days, my mama, my dad, my wife and I, then our children worked in it. My aunts, my uncles, and then Philip and Valerie, they took it over, and they had their kids working in here. And of course, he does all the work now. I do all the talking, and he does all the work.
You're just a pretty face.
There you go. I have to agree with that. A good-looking face. But it's just been a great run. It's been 60 years, and we've had a lot of great people that have, you know, patronized our place for a long time. A lot of friends, and it's just been a... it's been a good run. We've been very, very fortunate and very, very thankful for the good things that have, you know, come our way. And Philip and Val and his kids are working in here now, and they're doing a magnificent job with it. They do all the right things and keep it up, and we hope to keep it going, you know.
Yeah.
I don't know about another 60, but we want to go as long as we can. Let's hope so. Yes.
Now, I see, while, you know, some things have changed over the years, you still have little pieces of history still hanging in the building, right?
Oh, yes. Well, we got, of course, Mom and Daddy's pictures up there, and it's just a, you know, family place, and it's always, because it's our place. It belongs to everybody, you know.
Yeah.
And one of the most unique and under-known about projects is the steps. If you look outside in one of the flower beds, that was one of the things that Dad was able to get from the original Murphy's. So when you come walking by, people look at his flowers because he's got an amazing green thumb with that. But then when you don't realize is that's the steps that really we were able to take our first steps on, you know, to begin in a restaurant, in the restaurant business, trying to figure out what to do and when to do it. But those steps out there are the original steps that went to the original Murphy's, because the building is no longer there. That went away a long time ago.
But that's awesome to still have that little piece of history.
Yes. Oh, absolutely.
Yes. And in the original building, really, when we first got there, we lived in the building. Like most of the old downtown Hammond, you know, buildings that are there, everybody, you know, they had the business downstairs and lived upstairs. But we lived in the building for 5 years. So it's, you know, a lot of great memories there, and a lot of great memories here. And it's just been a good run.
Yeah.
We've had a really, really good run. And a lot of people have just been very, very nice to us. You know, as Frank Spalitta with S&W, we've been with them forever. And the sales rep that we have here, it's been with us for 40 years. You know, Tim Costanza has been with F&W, I say forever, almost as long as I've been around. Not quite, but close. And just been great to us, and just very fortunate, very, very fortunate.
So I know while some things have changed on your original menu, y'all sticking to a lot of the same roots that you started off with, and a lot of that being keeping things fresh and homemade.
Absolutely. We are very fortunate that we had such amazing people who have worked here. You know, and again, being younger, and you know how family businesses are, you grow up there, you kind of you just learn, you learn your roots. You learn the values that were taught. And, you know, I was fortunate enough to work a little bit with my grandmother, not as much as I wish that I would have, and with some of the ladies who she worked with. And, you know, if it wasn't good enough for them or it wasn't right, then it just wasn't right. Never went out, never was going to happen. Yeah. And what we were able to do is, you know, and Dad told me a long time ago, if I ever wanted to stay in this restaurant business, I had to learn how to cook and I had to be in the kitchen, which, you know, and that's where I took it to a challenge. It was a lot of fun to learn and do these things, and a lot of learning. Yeah. But the ladies who were back there really instilled in me on how to begin cooking, you know, to learn how to mix the ingredients, to make sure that you start off with chopping your fresh seasonings from there. So our dishes start from the ground up. We make our salad dressings all from scratch. We make all of our soups and bases for sauces. We still mix our flours for our fried food. We're back there cutting fish, peeling shrimp, deveining them, and doing all the things that the ladies who work with me and train me on how to go about doing these things, they instilled it. They're the ones who, I gotta say, I learned the most from, was working just around here, being as a kid, picking up stuff, waking up early in the morning to cut fish, those type of things. So, you know, for us, really, there may be an item or two that we don't make in-house, but when you come here, you are truly getting something that was made the day of by, you can tell the same lady who would have made it, or if I was making it, you'll know every time that you came in that your dish was prepared by this person every single time that they came through.
I know you even mentioned your catfish still tastes the exact same.
Oh yeah, well, when you come to Murphy's and you get catfish today, it's the same fish that you got, you know, in 1963. You know, all of it, it's all, you know, done and prepared the same way. It's cut by hand. Oysters are fresh, fish is fresh, the gravy, the red gravy, the, you know, meatballs and spaghetti, that recipe goes back generations, and it's, you know, the same as you would have got at grandma's house and mama's house. It's the same gravy that you get here today. Of course, Phillip makes it, and it's all done the right way, and it's done the old way. And, you know, we've always believed that when you prepare stuff and you fix it, if it's not good enough for us, it's not good enough for the people who work in the front door, you know, walk in the front door. You have to have a good product, and there's no shortcuts to doing it right. Absolutely. You know, you got to do it from scratch. That's just the way that it's done. And you want to, you know, you always want the consistency and people to remember, you know, as it was in back then, is how it has to be, you know, it has to be today.
And we've been very fortunate to work with good companies, good vendors. You know, you don't have to worry about the items coming in, when they're going to be there. You don't have to worry about the quality of the stuff that you're going to be receiving in, as you know. And that takes a big load of it. It takes a whole team of people and a whole network of people to be able to produce an item that goes out to a customer, you know, and it begins from the sales. It begins from the company buying the groceries in. It just, the receiving them, storing them, all the way. There's different phases and facets to what you do.
Well, it's clear that you guys have built a legacy here, which is no surprise why you actually were the recipients of a recent award for Taste of Tangy.
We did, and that was an amazing experience, you know, and it was very much out of the blue, you know, and I joke about it, and I kid, and we think about it. We don't even realize sometimes how long we've been around. We work every day. We come in every day. There's very few times you're not going to come in and see a family member who's here, whether it be my mom, my dad, my wife, myself. You just forget that you've been around for so long, and you've seen so many different changes of it. We were very fortunate that they did give us the, for our 60th anniversary, we received the first legacy award that's out there, and very exciting day. You know, just very unexpected going into the Columbia Theater and being up on stage in front of your peers, because this was an audience full of people. Yeah. You know, it was a kind of a humbling experience to go through.
That had to be a proud moment for you.
Oh, absolutely. You know, I always wished that, you know, Mom and Daddy could see Murphy's today.
They would be proud.
Oh yeah. What we did is we just kind of made a small little collection of items that have stayed with us throughout the years. We had the traditional bread pudding, where we have rum sauce on top made with raisins. We have our homemade strawberry cheesecake. And that one throughout the years has been, both of those, it's a fight to see which one is the top seller. They are literally neck and neck all the time, and they're easy to sell. People recognize them, they know them. They've had them numerous times, so they don't feel awkward going and ordering it and wondering if it's going to be something they're interested in.
Yeah.
Of course, you can't beat the onion rings or the crab claws, which we have for appetizers. Now, every day we cut onions, and that's not necessarily the most fun job, but it is definitely important to make sure that you get fresh onions and fresh onion rings, because when we come in, people, that's probably the easiest sell item that we have. Everybody comes in and gets an order of onion rings to start off with. I think they come here when they want to cheat a little bit on the diet, or if they want to go back to throw back a memory of what they used to eat whenever they were kids or with their grandparents. Crab claws, those, you can't mess those up. Those things are, if you get a good product and you just lightly fry those things, and they're good. And of course, the seafood platter we've had, it's our fried catfish, fried shrimp, fried oysters, our stuffed crab, and the stuffed crab recipe that goes all the way back to Mama Vita. And that one hits everybody's boxes, and then you can get something on there for everybody. And then, of course, the spaghetti and meatballs. And the biggest pasta day that we have is no doubt Sunday. It's Sunday after church, everybody comes for their spaghetti and meatballs. And, that's a lot of fun with that. And, that was one of the sauces. It's amazingly simple as far as the number of ingredients that go into it. It is the same pot that we used. It hasn't changed. And I can't even tell you.
Since day one.
Oh, and that's amazing, because it's so weird because you get used to doing things over and over, repetitive. Our business is very repetitive. You do the things, the same steps every day, no matter what. And we're now adding in, we do all these things in the same pots. So, that to me is something I take pride in, just making sure that, I got the same spoon my grandmother used, and I can tell you which one it was. And, we even have the spoons, the pots, the pans, the saute pans, everything is original Murphy seafood. Now, some of them have worn out throughout the years, and we've replaced them with some new stuff. But for the most part, it's taken a step back.
You mentioned that this is a great place to come for a good cheat day, but you also have, a lot of healthy options here for people who want that choice. Your salad bar, for instance, with all your homemade salad dressings and all the fresh ingredients you have there.
Absolutely. Well, and again, with changes throughout the years, people's diets have changed. People's time that they have to be able to spend going out. So salad bar was an excellent thing. That was one back in the early 80s, Dad, I would say,
is when
we originally started with a salad bar, and then it was the old salad bar and the old P-Row.
Yeah.
And that's where it all began.
Yeah.
And then we diversified the menu. Of course, we have a large grill section, a different pasta section that goes through. So we're probably about 50-50 fried food to alternatives to fried food. So we pride ourselves on having something that everybody should be able to enjoy, and we can do different types of cooking methods where we do it on the grill. We do traditional old broiling with these things. We saute in the pan. So as time has made us get better at what we do and do different with eating habits, we've adjusted and done. So now we're about 50-50 fried food, traditional. So you definitely can come in on that day, you feel like stepping back and having the onion rings, or you can come in and not feel bad about having the grilled chicken or the grilled fish or the tuna dishes that we have. So you have a good selection and a lot of alternate choices for everybody.
Yeah. And I think besides just the variety in your menu, you also have a great space, so it's perfect for large groups to get together.
We added the back dining room, and we added some smaller dining rooms because we had a lot of guests that were coming with special events that they wanted to have, and they wanted it, of course, in a private room. So we were fortunate back in the early 80s, along with a lot of the good changes that they made to help us to still be here, we added the back dining room.
We've had baby showers and christenings and weddings and everything, proposals, and we've had everything here.
It's been 60 years of serving your community. I know this month you guys have been celebrating the 60th anniversary.
Yes.
And you've been doing a contest on social media, right?
We have. We've had different giveaways and different offerings where you post a picture. Just say, you know, show your friends that you came to visit us and take a picture of your plate, whichever you prefer. If you like it, send it out there, you know. And social media has changed our world. And, you know, and even a dinosaur like Murphy's is still not immune to doing these things. And we've done a few giveaways, and we have a few other things that are up our sleeves for the rest of the month that we'll be doing.
Hey, well, thank you both so much for having us over today and sharing your history and seeing some of the delicious food you guys are offering. If you could just remind everybody your hours of operation.
Thank you very much. We're open actually Tuesday through Sunday from 11 till 9:30, and we're actually or till the last customer comes through the door. So
awesome.
We appreciate you guys coming over there and thinking about us and helping celebrate 60 years.
Absolutely. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Be sure to stop by and show Murphy's some local love.
You can't afford to be without your vehicle. Bobby and his team of professionals at A1 Quick Oil will get you back on the road fast and with the job done right. All technicians are 100% certified. Behind Napa off Highway 51 North, give Bobby a call.
Here at A1, we don't work on cars, we fix them.